I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, we're going to have a fast look at how you can use Resolve 12.5's new Resolve Effects filters in conjunction with the new ability to use the Effects Tracker to match move their position to match a scene. So, in this shot right here, I'll go ahead and turn looping on. You can see that this fellow's being confronted by a delivery person. And I'm going to open up the Open Effects browser. I'm going to press Option S to add a node, and I'm going to drag a lens flare onto that node. And I'm just going to position it right where the light is coming out. I'm going to choose a different preset. I'm going to go ahead and just use this modern sci-fi preset, because we just want to give this scene a little more cowbell than it really deserves. When I play through this clip, obviously the flare doesn't integrate because it's not moving with anything. But this is an easy thing to fix. All I need to do is to go into the tracker palette, and from the mode pop-up, which defaults to window, I can choose effects. This is the effects tracker, and to use it, all I have to do is go down to the bottom corner and click this Add Tracker Point button, which puts a little tracker point crosshairs into the viewer. If I move the pointer over it, I get this moving cursor, and I can click and drag to position that crosshairs over any high contrast detail that I know isn't going to go off screen or be obscured in some other way. So I'm just going to drop it onto that little bit of bokeh up in the tree, which actually should work. So now all I need to do is click the track forward button and let Resolve do all the work trying to figure out the motion of the scene. And you'll notice that as soon as I track that in, that effect just goes ahead and starts match moving itself into the scene. So at this point, I'm done. All I had to do was perform the track, and Resolve knows what to do. The effects track is going to work with any of the filters in the Resolve Effects library that are capable of being positioned. So, for example, if I were to drag the light rays Resolve Effects filter on here instead, and I am going to customize this a little bit so that the light looks like it's coming straight out from that central area. Go ahead and lengthen those just for fun. But I can also track the position of the scene for purposes of this other filter. So again, all I need to do is to create a tracker, drop it on a feature that I want to track, go ahead and track forward. And so now I can see that those light rays are following the position of the scene. If you want to learn more about Resolve's new features, how to get started in Resolve, or if you want to dive deep into editing and or color grading in DaVinci Resolve, you should check out my library of different training titles at rippletraining.com. I'm Alexis Van Hurkman. Thanks for watching.